All right, welcome back, everybody. The Pan-African Business Forum is a platform for Africans from all over the continent, regardless of race, tribe, gender, or religion, to come together to make a difference. The forum is a private initiative to increase the socio-economic development of the continent through a combination of carefully considered programs and projects that are developed both by Africans locally and out of the continent. Now, the aim is to challenge African governments to strive to develop their countries while discouraging corruption and nepotism. Joining us now is the CEO and the chairperson of the Pan-African Business Forum, and I'm talking about Ladislas Prosper Agbesi. It's good to have you. Welcome to Morning Live.
Thank you. Welcome. Thanks. See you. It's a great pleasure to see you.
Thank you very, very much for being here. Give us a bit of a background on the Pan-African Business Forum. When was it established? Why was it established?
Basically, the Pan-African Business Forum is as an initiative of like-minded African from a certain kind of underprivileged background. In 1999-2000, that the scope of the development of this continent must come into for if we come to for us to set up a very extensive coalition for the reinforcement of investment for the continent, especially creating an enabled environment for the direct foreign investment and the socio-economic development for this our continent, their continent. Mm-hmm. And all this can be done through certain kind of two advocacy policies and investment ground. These are the issues we look at in our continent, seeing that only we as a youth coming together, creating this kind of environment to activate the foreign direct investment to enable a socio-economic development for our continent.
And the aim, let's talk about the broader aims of the Pan-African Business Forum.
We have two advocacy policies. The first one is the advocacy policies is to strive into certain kind of reforms in all in the continents, reforms into government reform in terms of attracting more investment in the country, supporting education drive, supporting where there's a conflict and resolution, try to support anything to do the food securities. And we do those things in partnership with certain kind of agencies where we invite them through seminars and play a greater role in terms of reforms in certain kind of countries. Hence our participation in many of activities in the African Union, European Union, so certain kind of aspect of it.
It's quite interesting because I know that one of the activities that the forum is very, very much so involved in is lobbying for a better environment for businesses to operate in. And I think a lot of people do get nervous operating within the African continent. What is it the forum does?
Now, basically, we enforce certain kind of reforms in the betterness of this continent. Wherever we see there's a gap, we come in and we participate in it, we support it through talking to the government, stakeholders, private sector, and multinationals. And we play that kind of role in terms of how we lobby into them. In the case of African Union, where Constantinism has become essential issues for the African Union, where we have to sit down and meet with a government institution, multilateral, and discuss with them the benefit, why this thing had to be done. And the group has been very creative, very aggressive in terms of achieving those kind of results. Even the UNICEF, the lady who has been appointed Pan-African Business Forum, have played a greater role. We work with agencies, African Union, European Union, United Nations. We have partners over there. We work together in terms of building up the betterness of the socio-economic development of our continent, their continent, Africa. Yeah. We cannot achieve that. You see, if you look at what the trend the continent is going through since the last 5 or 6 years, if we don't come into it as a private sector to play a greater role, and we leave it only in the hands of the politicians, we think that there must be kind of a combination, harmonization between the private sector and the government to drive a betterness of this our continent.
Quite interesting. I'm having a look here that it says that the forum engages in two separate lines of activity. Firstly, the police advocacy, and then African Investment Fund. Tell me about these activities.
The activities is the policy advocacy is what I just spoke about earlier on. Mm-hmm. Is a framing in any areas where there can be sort of reform. We work with the judiciaries, the financial sectors. We look at a very enabled environment where we can accelerate the growth of the development, the DFI, direct foreign investment for government. So we come with through seminars. We analyze the scope of development policies, the very good investment policies in the country, and we look at it how those one can benefit local and a foreign direct investment. And that's why we sit down with the stakeholders, the government, and we send our team there, we discuss with them, we found the seminars, we found this research, and we put it on the table, we support them. That's what we do. Yeah.
I know that the forum was very instrumental in carrying the mobilization of the South African and Angolan communities. How is that going?
Basically, to come to that, what has informed Pan-African Business Forum to involve into the policies of South Africa is by the good news of the 20th achievement of South Africa. If you look at a country like South Africa, with the ANC, with the tripartite alliances, achieving a greater result from a junk state of Standard & Poor's BB for South Africa in 1994, and from 135 for GDP, and today we are at 123 billion GDP in 20 years. I think that is a great achievement for ANC, led by tripartite alliances of COSATU and SACP. And if you look at within that 20 years of achievement, you see that 58,000 new classrooms has been built. You have 18,000 cleaning schools has been built in this country. You have 17,000 provincial roads who has been rehabilitated. And you have close to 7,000 national roads who has been done. And you have the SASA, who was the social grant, which have increased to 16 million. Yeah. It's the only country where people get a free a social grant. And you look at also access to water, which is close to 79% in the country of within 20 years. And you have the water assessment of 83%. And if you look at where the ANC of the tripartite alliances come from, you look at it's a dual economy.
Yeah.
Before
yeah.
1994, we are having a one economy called a national NP. Which was with a minority population with a developing economy, where the majority were in the developing economy, junk than a Djibouti economy, born than Niger. And after 1994, ANC with the tripartite alliance combined that economy together, which become a dual economy, harmonized economy, and become the strongest one at this time. So
All
it informed Pan-African Business Forum that this is the place for we African to make our hope into ANC, that we have to participate into it. And the response was very great, where we called the embassies all over at Sheraton. We have 47 embassies from all over, which responded to that.
All right, we have to unfortunately leave it there, but I think you've given us a great indication of what the forum is actually doing. That was the chairman and the CEO of the Pan-Africa Business Forum, Ladislas Prosper Agbesi, giving us more insights on what the forum is all about. Now, the Pan-African Business Forum is organizing an event aimed at mobilizing the African diaspora living in South Africa, and the event will be aimed at mobilizing South African naturalized by informing them of their right to register to vote in the upcoming elections on the 7th of May 2014. So again, thank you very much. Keep up that good work. All right, let's take a break. We'll be with you after this. Stay tuned.